Consider. Assess. Implore. Surrender.
Subdued at last, it begs for its life.
Spare me. Join me. Wield me. Become absolute.
It pleads because it knows I am its master. I will finish this.
The brain is on the cusp of its final thought, and it's taking all of the Emperor's strength to keep it there. An opportunity, perhaps. You glimpse the lifelong destiny promised by your father. Enslave, dominate, ruin. In your father's name, you must seize your rightful claim to the brain, not destroy it. If you do not, then he will flay and shred your mind, so it cannot even comprehend the horrors he will plague you with.
This is the moment, my love. The moment in which we make a new world for ourselves.
Silence. The overbearing quiet of your father's disappointment before the rush of your tragic fall.
Thank you.
Everything you did, everything you sacrificed, it was worth it. For this.
It is done. The Absolute eradicated. Vengeance exacted. We are free. No more gods or monsters. Except those of our own making. And we are cleansed. The tadpoles are still at last. They cannot control us or turn us into abominations. Although in your case, the transformation may be an improvement, Iblis.
It makes little difference to me. I did what I had to secure my freedom. And in spite of your resistance to completing your evolution, you have proved a good ally. I'm glad you think so. I did my best.
Skvar, you may have succeeded, but I have failed. Gith's son is dead, and Vlakith has abandoned me. I will be hunted by her Inquisition to the ends of the world. I must leave. I have nothing more to gain by being here. It will be a restless life while the false queen reigns over my people. But a life nonetheless, and a free one. Yes, I will stay. My destiny is for neither Vlakith nor Orpheus to decree. It is mine. We fought well together. I will gladly fight with you again. If not the Astral Seas, then here, and wherever else we go.
The Githyanki leave at last. I feared they would make this world their own.
With the Githyanki gone, there's nothing left but the silence of the city. Smoldering, waiting to be rebuilt. But it seems that Gale's mind is elsewhere.
The crown. It's somewhere in the Giontha. If I salvage the stones, I can reforge it. With the crown in my hands, I would be unstoppable. The casts I weave would be mine to command. I would be more than the greatest wizard who ever lived. I would be a god. That day cannot come soon enough. But first, I must retrieve the crown. Have patience a while, and I will return to you. carrying immortality in one hand and offering you ascension with the other. I will be a god, as will you.
I swear, you ascend to unprecedented power one time, and then suddenly everyone's doing it. I do wonder how he'll fare when Mistra decides to crush him. It could be quite the show. But enough about the wizard. Let's talk about us.
What shall we do next?
Why bother? Let Baldur's Gate wear its scars proudly. Until the next crisis wipes it from the world entirely.
I will not be joining you. I fear my presence will be no more welcome in the streets of the city than it ever was.
Every Gaeth is an abomination. Maybe you're an exception. Maybe.
I will miss you, too.
Now that you no longer live in each other's minds, it's hard to tell if the Mind Flayer is being sincere, though perhaps no harder than it ever was. Your thoughts wander from your companions and everything you endured to your own piteous fate. If only you'd defied your father when you had the chance and freed yourself of your dark desires. But it's too late now. Your destiny is set. Your very blood shall clot with the urge, and that hungry desire will consume you. You may have freed the world from the control of the Netherbrain, but you are not yet free. Your father is angry. What foul punishment awaits you now that you have rejected him?
What are you doing? No!
You've butchered so many before. Each death a gift to your father. This one, you will take from him. This one is just for you. It's over, and it's all because of you. You, who were destined to become a thrall. Thanks to you, there will be no illithid empire, no death god's tyranny. You have earned your place amongst the legends of the Sword Coast. You are the saviors of Baldur's Gate.
There thou art, the dead three. Thy face is gone. Thy actions barely worthy of the name.
Didst truly believe thy ploy would succeed? Didst believe I would not notice? Thou sought to bolster thy strength by taking away the souls of mortals. But souls vanish when their hosts become mind flayers. Didst think the other gods would not notice? Gods thou may be, yet thou hast proven thyself fools, everyone. The supplication of Bane, the whimper of Baal, the death mule of Merkel, felled by mortals. I overestimated thee. They did not. Vermin, away. Thou wilt trouble us no more.